Okay, so what we have here is a switch we're going to be putting in, and putting in another one later. So we're going to use these things here. Put our ground wires together first. Okay, so we'll get our ground tail out to go to the two switches here. You want to make sure your wire is straight when you put any of these pressure lock connectors here. So you want them to look like that. So we'll get this back into the box out of the way here.
Did you find a blade?
Yes, I did. You took off about a half of an inch on the white here. This has three openings on it, so we're going to go one, make sure the insulation goes into the orange a little bit, two, and the third one we'll put in there later after we get the next switch in. So we'll get our ground wires back into the box here and back out of the way. This is the first switch we're going to hook up, and it's going to be the one that's going to be active, being used right now. We'll make our loop to actually make the screw turns. This ground wire out of the way. Now this wire is live, so we're going to hook the score here, and we'll score down here. And we're going to be careful not to touch anything grounded, and we're going to peel this insulation off down to the score here. So we're going to leave this off position. Now we'll get that ground wire out of the way there. Now we're going to go around this screw. Close this loop up a little bit better here, so bring it up a little bit and squeeze it. down like that. So now we can just leave this capped off until we're ready to put our next switch in. And we will bring our ground wire over. Okay, now this is the second switch. This trip is a little long. So this would be power going to the second switch, right? This is the load side of the switch we're hooking up at another time. We're not ready to hook it up now. And that's going to go to an outside light. So this we're going to leave. We have one space to hook the white wire up for the wire going to the light. We're going to put the other ground wire in the a wire nut here at when it's ready to hook that one up. So I'm going to keep these ground wires down away from everything. If I had one of those push-ins, I won't have to pigtail here later, but I don't have one, so I'm going to have to use a wire nut here when I add the other light in. Alrighty, thanks for watching. So that is how you wire a gang switch box
for the 100,000th time.